The limit comparison test works for a lot of series, and this video will encounter two examples. We will also see an example where the limit comparison test fails, even if we try some different comparison series. And unfortunately, it was exactly that series which I got on my own calculus exam almost 20 years ago. Back then I tried lots of comparison tests and other tests, which all failed. Now I know how to do it, and after watching this video, you will do too. Well, let's first do a series where the limit comparison test works nicely. We have our sum n from 1 to infinity of our an, where in this example an equals 1 over 2 to the power n minus 1. And we say, well, let's use as our bn 1 over 2 to the power n. Then we compute an over bn, the an and the bn. Simplify a bit, put the bn over here, divide by the highest number, by the 2 to the power n, and we have a 2 to the power minus n over here. Now we know that the sum of the bn of the 1 over 2 to the power n is convergent. It is 1 half plus 1 quarter plus 1 over 8 plus 1 over 16. So you know either graphically that the sum equals 1, or use the fact that it is a geometric series. Anyway, the sum n from 1 to infinity of the bn is convergent. The limit n to infinity an over bn equals 1, because then this 2 to the power minus n will cancel out, which is bigger than 0. So we can apply the limit comparison test. The sum of the bn is convergent, and the sum of the an is convergent. Then let's look into a series which looks really awkward. Sum n from infinity, 1 to infinity of the an, where the an are this expression 2 times n squared plus 3 times n divided by the square root of 5 plus n to the power 5. So what can we do? Well, if you want to find a suitable comparison series, you can often look what happens with the terms when they go to infinity. That will give you an idea of a suitable comparison series. So what happens if n goes to infinity? The 2n squared plus 3n will behave like 2 times n squared, and the square root will behave as the square root of n to the power 5. So we get bn, we will take bn as 2n squared divided by the square root of n to the power 5, or the n to the power 5 over 2, which simplifies to 2 divided by the square root of n. That will be the ID for our bn. Well, let's see whether it works. First we compute an over bn. So here we have our horrible an. We have to divide by 2 divided by square root of n. So dividing by that means multiplying by reverse by square root of n over 2. And then we can simplify this by dividing by the highest power, which is n to the power 5 over 2, which we divide out the 2's here. So, and we divide by n to the power 5 over 2, so we get a 1. Here we get a 3 divided by 2n. And in the numerator we also have to divide by n to the power 5 over 2, so inside the square root we have to divide by n to the power 5. So we have a 5 divided by n to the power 5, and then n to the power 5 divided by n to the power 5. So why did we do that? Well, we know that the sum n from 1 to infinity of the bn is divergent, because it's a b series, which b equals 1 half, which is smaller or equal than 1. Now if you take the limit n to infinity an over bn, so the limit of this expression over here, everything cancels out except for the 1 and the square root of 1, so we get a 1, which is bigger than 0. So we can apply our limit comparison test, and we know that our series of the an is divergent as well. You may think that we needed to do a lot of work, but look, the an looked really awkward, and we still need only, well, a few lines, and then the limit comparison test already works. It really works like a charm, doesn't it? Let's go to example 3, a famous one. Sum n from 1 to infinity, equals 1 over n times ln of 1. So what can we do? Oh, we can try bn equals 1 over n. Then an over bn becomes the an over here, divided by 1 over n, so multiply by n. So we get 1 over ln of n. If we now take the limit n to infinity, we get 0. Ah, that's a pity. Limit comparison test does not work. Well, let's try another bn, 1 over n squared. Now we take an over bn, again here the an, and we divide by 1 over n squared, so we'll multiply by n squared, take limit n over ln of n. Hey, that's a pity, we use L'Hopital or whatever, but you'll see that it tends to infinity, and again, limit comparison test does not work. So can we try some comparison test, like is 1 over n ln n, is it smaller than 1 over n times 1 over n to the power epsilon, provided we pick epsilon bigger than 0 small enough, because then we would be happy, because then the series of this one converges, so then you can show that this one converges. But no matter how small you pick your epsilon, your n to the power epsilon will always win in the end of the ln of n. So this argument will not work. This is the argument I tried, by the way, on the exam after all the other ones. And I knew that something fishy was going on, and it is wrong. So, by the way, what does work for this last series? Well, limit comparison test does not work, comparison test does not work, but the integral test does work for this one. Forgot about that one. Well, you certainly won't.